your husband's Lee Stoller. Was he in the music business?
No, neither one of us were in it. We just kind of fell into it because when he heard me, I never sang in front of anybody. Because I guess it was a fear of rejection. And from the time of high school days, there were things that I went through that kind of stuck with me. And I thought, well, I won't open my mouth again because I was afraid that someone would knock me back down. So when he heard me singing that day, it was a surprise to him too. And he started sending little tapes around.
And these little tapes led to some of the most requested songs of all time, like Shake Me, I Rattle.
Shake me, I rattle. Squeeze me, I cry. Please take me home and love me. I was passing by a toy shop on the corner of the square where a girl was looking in the window there. She was looking at a dolly in a dress of rosy red, and around the pretty dolly hung a little sign that said, shake me, I rattle, squeeze me, I cry. Please take me home and love me. I recalled another toy shop on a square so long ago, where I saw a little dolly that I wanted so. I remember how I longed to make it mine, and around that other dolly hung another little sign. Shake me, I rattle, squeeze me, I cry. I had counted my pennies, just a penny shy. Shake me, I rattle, squeeze me, I cry. Please take me home and love me. It was late and snow was falling as the shoppers hurried by, past the girl at the window with her little head held high. They were closing up the toy shop as I hurried through the door, just in time to buy the dolly that her heart was longing for. Shake me, I rattle, squeeze me, I cry. And I gave her the dolly that we both had longed to buy.